So I'll try to tell you about the Lakshmi, the symbol of Lakshmi. Sri Lakshmi is the symbol of the completeness of womanhood. She brings wealth, prosperity, auspiciousness. She brings in understanding, generosity, peace and joy. She is the giver of all the blessings. The symbol of Lakshmi is that she stands on the lotus, which is pink in color. Pink color is the warmth of a motherhood. In India, even a small girl is called as mother. So this, in the various aspects of Lakshmi, the symbol is that first, she is a very warm person. Also in one hand she has the lotus, which is also pink in color. That also suggestive of her warmth. Even a funny type of a moth with all kinds of thorns attached to his body enters into a lotus. He finds a place where he can rest. She makes all the guests to come in her house and have the best bed and the best food. Normally, the men bring in a guest and the wife receives him and looks after him. So, it is suggestive that we have to look after any type of a guest who comes to our house and should completely devote ourselves to the looking after of the guest who is from outside. She is standing on the lotus and wearing also a pink sari. That is, you have to have balance to stand on a thing like lotus, because she is surrounded by water. And there are many animals around. Beast-like people who try to entice her. So she has to have a complete balance. Also, she has two hands with the lotus, and with two other hands she is giving, and with another hand she is blessing. This one means that she should be generous, she should be giving always to others, not for herself. She should not spend all the money on herself and nothing for the children or for the guests or for others. So it is the Lakshmi who has to give, who has to be generous. I have seen those people in Sahaja Yoga are generous, their wives may not be, and then they suffer a lot. But if the wife is generous, she's rewarded, the whole family is rewarded 100 times. Generosity is like this, that you have one door open through which everything is coming in, and you open another door by giving. So there's a very good circulation. I enjoy my generosity the most, if it is generosity. And generosity is so rewarding, that it is unbelievable how the divine forces help a person who is generous. I'll give you an example. I had a friend who said she wanted a sari from the foreign countries, these imported saris. And I had two of them, and I told another lady who was very miserly that I would like to give away these two saris to her. So she said, "You have only these two left now, why do you want to give her this sari?" She was miserly type. We were talking in the kitchen, but somebody rang the bell and I opened the door. He had brought two saris from Africa, because some lady who had gone to Africa had sent them. So I said, "Why did she send me saris?" He said, "Because you had given her saris when she went, so she has sent you these." And when I opened the saris, they were exactly the same, the ones I had with me. So I took out both the saris and showed her, see, this is the example. This is how it is. Always everything comes back to you when you are kind to others or if you are generous to others. You will find later on yourself, and so many have already found. They can't understand from where the money is coming. Just it works out that you get money whenever you want. Just pocket it and it comes to you. People are who are meticulously counting their money all the time, every morning, are never satisfied, and also they haven't got the blessings of any kind. But if you just leave the worry of money to God, everything works out. So, what do we understand? That it is all in the hands of God Almighty. After coming to Sahaja Yoga, you don't have to worry about anything. Leave it in the hands of God. And everything will work out. There is no need for you to go on telling people that, oh, I'm so much worried, I have no money. That shows that you are not yet Sahajyogis. So, if you have to improve those who are your neighbors or your friends or your country, first of all, you have to be very mature Sahajyogis. So the Lakshmi is already awakened within you. She resides in your Nabhi Chakra. So, with your Lakshmi awakened, why should you worry about money? So then, this last, her symbolic hand says that those who are under your protection, you must look after them. That means you have to bless everyone who comes in contact with you. And you have to worry about all the people who are under your control. This symbol is not only for the ladies, but more for the men. A man who is in the business has to respect his wife. His wife should be respectable. If she is not, then auspiciousness will not come in that family. So you get all these blessings of Lakshmi if your housewife is a good person. This symbol of Lakshmi is expressing a kind of a personality that is expected of a woman or a man who have got the blessings of money. So that is the, I was telling you about the first day, what is it, second day, what is it. But main thing is that on a Diwali day, we have to worship the Lakshmi. So today when we are worshipping Lakshmi, the men also have to know that they have to have a complete balance in life. So there are, as I said, many aspects, but one of them very important is that Sri Rama killed Ravana on 10 days before, they say, and was crowned on the, today, he was crowned today. So his wife, Sita, she was also made the queen, and in their life it is shown how she remained absolutely dedicated to him. So in Sahaj culture, we have to be special people. We cannot be like other people who are just running after money and doing everything just to ruin themselves. So that in Sahaj culture, we have to meditate, get our satisfaction about everything within ourselves, and also we have to be like the Lakshmi children, the children of Lakshmi. So there are two aspects of this thing we have understood is that Lakshmi fulfills all our monetary needs. Plus, also, she gives us all the balance, all the joy, all the bliss in the family. Now, the problem is with us that unless and until we meditate, unless and until we reach that state of satisfaction, we cannot see the work of this divine power. For all the people from Eastern countries could worship the Lakshmi, or you can say worship their own Kundalini, then whole of this problem of money will be solved. And such a change will come that those countries which today appear to be poorer than the rest of the European world will become quite rich by the blessings of Sri Lakshmi. Now, I have to take you to a very subtler side of life. And that subtler side is that with the blessings of Sri Lakshmi or Mahalakshmi, now you have achieved your self-realization. And the Mahalakshmi principle is that you rise much above your mundane life into the realm of self-realization. So by her blessings, you become like lotuses yourselves. Now you become the another aspect of Diwali, which means the rose of lights. Sri Rama's crowning or any other aspect of Sri Lakshmi here now becomes your own crowning. That is, you have now entered into the kingdom of God. And once you are there, then automatically, as the citizens of God's kingdom, you are blessed. And as you become the lotuses, then you start spreading your fragrance all around. The generosity at another level, at a lower level, is transformed into this universal love. Whatever you gain, whatever joy, satisfaction, vibrations, knowledge, all that you want to give it to others. You want to spread it because now you got the reality and you don't want to keep it to yourself. You think it is very important that everyone in the world should know about reality. This is significant in putting these lights, that now you are the lights.